Welcome to World Action and Reaction News. Today's news headlines are: Defense Research and Development Organization, DRDO, consultant Lt. Gen J.P. Singh, Retd, told TOI that the jackets are under production at Ordnance Factory in Kanpur and set for induction in next few months. He also added that the new jackets would also give a feel of modular clothing to troops. The design is yet to reach the Prime Minister's office and the approval is pending. Once the PMO approves it, the jacket will be ready for manufacturing. Army to get 464 T-90 Russian tanks soon. ₹13.448 crore deal to have Make in India element. The new purchase to guard western frontiers with Pakistan. The 10 new regiments of T-90 MS tanks, equipped with thermal imaging night sights to allow the tank commander to hit at enemy locations even during night battles, will strengthen Army's firepower along the land border stretch with Pakistan from Jammu in north till the western flank in Gujarat. The Indian Navy conducted trials of French Rafale, Swedish Saab Sea Gripen, Russian MiG-29K and American F-18 for its $11 billion, ₹75,000 crore, fighter jet procurement deal for its aircraft carriers. The Indian Navy recently invited foreign vendors to carry out trials to see if the planes could operate off the aircraft carrier INS Vikramaditya, reported India Today Saturday. All the four defence companies to a request for information issued by the Indian Navy in January to procure 57 multi-role combat aircraft for its carrier. The foreign vendors were asked to prove that their aircraft would be able to operate off our Russian-origin aircraft carrier INS Vikramaditya, a senior Navy source was quoted as saying by the broadcaster. Aircraft manufacturers were asked to provide more inputs on their respective planes' capabilities to be able to take off and land at the Vikramaditya, the sources said. The trials were held at INS Vikramaditya's home base in Karwar in Karnataka. Having developed an array of defense systems over the past 5 decades, Defense Research and Development Organization is now set to tap the overseas export market. At a customary news briefing on the sidelines of 3-day scientific exhibition Science for Soldiers and Society organized at Combat Vehicle Research and Development Establishment, S. Christopher, DRDO chairman, said marketing of Indian defense products is being keenly pursued. We are in talks with a few friendly foreign nations. When Indian Army upgrades to the latest technology, the older systems become redundant. These systems have overseas market, he said without naming the potential foreign customers with whom India is in touch with. Potential products are, radar, Astrom missile, Pinaka Mark 1 and 2 missiles, tactical sonar systems, advanced lightweight torpedo and hypersonic missile BrahMos 2. Doval also joined other security officials in calling on XI, who said that BRICS should play a bigger role in international affairs by Sybil Dasgupta Beijing, National Security Advisor Ajit Doval's meeting with Chinese President Xi Jinping did not yield any breakthrough that could end the current standoff in Doklam. A bipartisan group of American senators have sought enhanced cooperation with India in Afghanistan, including increasing New Delhi's role in helping the Afghan security forces, a move that could annoy Pakistan. The lawmakers have introduced a legislative amendment to the National Defense Authorization Act, NDAA, 2018, in the Senate to support their demand. India is one of the biggest providers of developmental assistance to war-torn Afghanistan. The amendment seeks increasing India's role in assisting the Afghan security forces through logistics support, threat analysis, intelligence, materiel, and maintenance support. Improve the provision by India of humanitarian and disaster relief assistance to Afghanistan, including through the provision of logistics support by India, joint training between Afghanistan and India, and combined military planning by Afghanistan and India for humanitarian assistance and disaster relief missions in Afghanistan, the amendment says. The Advanced Offshore Patrol Vessel, AOPV, constructed at Goa Shipyard Limited, GSL, for the mission requirement of the Sri Lanka Navy, arrived at the Colombo Harbour this Friday. Upon its arrival at the Colombo port, the brand new vessel that is expected to join the SLN fleet was warmly received by the Navy in compliance with naval traditions. The ship is commanded by Captain N. Nishantha Amarosa and its crew consists of 18 officers and 100 sailors. Subsequently, the commander of the Navy, Vice Admiral Ravindra Wijgunaratne, made an inspection visit on board ship and supervised the functional and operational aspects of the new AOPV. The ship will be commissioned by the President and Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces Maithripala Sirisena, at the Colombo Harbour premises on August 2, as SLNS Sahurala.
Thanks for watching. I hope you like this news. Please share your views in comment box. Please like and share this video. Press subscribe button and bell for auto update to you regarding my channel World Action and Reaction News, WARN.